My name is Dennis Moki. I'm from Kenya, from Egerton University, and we were working, my colleague and I, Charles couldn't be here today, but I guess he'll be here tomorrow. We were working on a public health gateway in Kenya. So we did a small research back home, and we visited Nakuru Provincial District Hospital. And out of the 80-bed capacity ward that is the hospital has, like 90% of the occupants, first of all, the ward is almost fully occupied. 90% of the occupants are victims of motorcycle accidents. And these victims, like 80% of them are men aged between 19 and 35. So basically the youth. And you know, in our country, especially in developing countries, is the youth that are vibrantly, you know, building the economy. So we thought that this poses a great danger, I mean, in development in our country. And we thought, why not maybe come up with a solution? I mean, try to figure out where the problem is and come up with a solution. So we figured out that there's been an increased motorcycles in the country after the government abolished import tax on motorcycles in 2002. The number has really grown really fast, and now motorcycles are being used as taxis. We call them border border back home. So the increase in the number has not reflected in the increase in the number of roads. So basically, we are competing for the same space. I mean, the same space that vehicles use, and is the same space that these motorcycles are using. So that strain of the resources has caused many accidents, and there are very notorious regions that are very prone to accidents, and these are well known to people. I mean, the doctors, the police officers, because they're the ones who receive these accidents and they're first responders to the accidents. So these people have, you know, better information about these black spots where they're located and, you know, the situation of the infrastructure. And we thought maybe if we can harness that information from these professionals and distribute this information actively to the motorcycle riders and anybody else using the road, maybe we could help reduce the incidents. So that's what we did, and we came up with a public health gateway. Okay, so the public health gateway has two main parts. There's a web portal and there's a mobile application. The web portal is where the professionals, that is the doctors and the police officers and any government official with the relevant information, feeds all this information about road accidents. So we record this information on a web portal which runs on the cloud. And for you to access that portal, you have to authenticate you via federated authentication. In Kenya, we're using KNET, obviously. If you are recognized by any federated authentication, you can be able to access the portal. So the, after you log in, you're able to see a form, I mean, a map which has all, you can search anywhere and locate where the accident has occurred. And from there, you can record an incident. There are various information that we collect, like the, you'll see the form in my next slides. And the technologies that we used, we're using a RESTful API, it's called Z-Library, and we're using Future Gateway for analyzing the accidents. After the accidents have been recorded, we also record the intensity of the accident. Like, I mean, if you're a police officer and you record an accident, you can tell the intensity. Like on a scale of 1 to 5, this accident rates like 3, this accident is 5, depending on the severity, with 5 being the most severe accidents. So from that information, we can analyze an area and maybe mark it as a black spot or a yellow spot or a safe region. Okay. So at Catania, we went to the Hackfest at Catania, where we were trained about using the Lead G Library and the Future Gateway. Those are the tools that we chose to implement our use case with. And the Future Gateway is set up on a VM in Catania, and the G-Library is basically a REST API for accessing data. The data is fed through the G-Library and is, you know, invoked back through the G-Library. And this data is also fed on a live basis. Like if I record an accident right now, it broadcasts to all the active devices. If you have the application on your phone, it will broadcast immediately to your active device and tell you like, hey, there's been an accident here, please proceed with caution, something like that. And the more these accidents are recorded, the more we are analyzing it in the background and marking regions off on the map. So yeah, that's how the form looks like. After you are authenticated, you can be able to access this form, and you see you are able to fill all those fields that are there. And from that information, we analyze it in the background and realize that maybe this area is too dangerous and maybe this area is not very dangerous. And that is actually mapped out on a map. If you launch your application, you're able to see that instantly. This is how you see the map. Like, for example, this was a use case. We were trying to experiment how to record accidents. And the pinpoints that you're seeing are accident points. Like, if an accident occurs at an area, you can search it or maneuver through the map. It's just a basic Google map. You maneuver through the map and find the region, and you record it. It will place a pin on that, as well as on the mobile device that everyone else is holding. And that is the result of an analyzer. You can see the red spots have been marked as very dangerous spots. So anytime you're riding, anytime you're approaching that region, you'll get a voice notification warning on your device that, you know what, you're approaching a very red, dangerous zone, so please proceed with caution. We are planning in future to integrate, you know, other information like, you know, road safety rules, so that we can be giving these people, like, you need to keep, if it's in Kenya, you need to keep left. If it's in South Africa, I think it's left as well. In Catania, it's right. So we need to give this information actively to people. You know, actually, we realize that most of these motorcycle riders, they are not really well trained. So it's out of ignorance that they don't know these rules. So if you provide that information, somehow we'll get them to follow the rules. Yeah, so those are the three major ratings on the mobile device. The green one, the first one that you see, is the safe zone. So if no accident has been recorded here, you'll see a green zone, a green area. That's a 1 kilometer radius. The center is where you're located. So within a 1 kilometer radius, you'll see like this area is green, so no accidents recorded so far. And then we put a threshold on the medium accident zone, which is color-coded yellow. And the more accidents increase, the color changes now to red. And the red is a black spot zone. That is a very dangerous region. And now from here is where we keep giving you like alerts like every other minute, like you need to ride safely, you need to do this and this, something like that. Okay, so that is a poster outlining how the whole use case works. The top layer is where you feed information to the gateway through a web interface, which I just showed you. So you can feel in the form you saw there were, you know, the type of the roads and the severity of the accidents. All that information is fed on the web interface through the top layer. Now on the middle layer is where the analysis happens. After the analysis has happened, we take that data and broadcast it immediately to the people holding the mobile devices. The mobile devices have the application installed in them, and it runs in the background. You don't need to launch it. As long as you're connected to the internet, the application runs in the background. But once you launch it, that's when you get to see the map. When it's running on the background, you only interact with it through voice commands. I mean, it gives you voice information like maybe an accident has been recorded. And then from the mobile devices, obviously the guy who is riding, he'll be cautious. I mean, that is the outcome. You're safe riding and reduced accidents on our roads. Yeah, so that's our Public Health Gateway from Kenya. Thank you.